song of love. Now you just keep taunting me with the memory of is a tender love, broken-hearted melody. Must you keep reminding me of the lips I long to kiss and the love I miss since he went away? Night and day I play that broken-hearted melody that he used to sing to me when our love was young and bright. And he held me tight. Suddenly I found I was heaven bound. Broken-hearted melody. Once you were a song of love. Now you just keep taunting me. Is a tender love, oh, broken-hearted melody. Won't you bring him back to me? Sing to him until he yearns. For when he returns, no more will you play. Since he went away, broken-hearted melody.
I have to do it right because this man, you know, is a black belt in, I don't know, something. You know, he's Jamaican, so, you know, he do everything. Thank you all for coming out tonight. I'm just saying a quick hello. My name is Christopher Williams. I will be your host with the most, your MC from New York City. I'm trying to make it rhyme because I'm a rapper, but I'm not. But anyway, we're going to have fun tonight, all right? This is called the Big Awards. Big stands for Business Innovators and Game Changers. And we have some big people here who I consider, I want to say heroes, because what they do, the work they do in the community is heroic. And they don't do it, you know, yes, they're running businesses and they want to make money and provide for their families. But a lot of them are giving back to the community in a way that I think is important. So we're going to celebrate them tonight. We're going to celebrate you all for being here. So we'll get started soon. I just wanted to say good evening and welcome you all because you all look so beautiful. You all look so fashionable. When I grow up, I hope I can look as sharp as you do. Got to lose a few pounds. But I'm getting there. All right. Y'all ready to have fun?
Yeah.
No. Okay. So I'm going to tell you where I'm from. I'm from Jamaica, West Indies. All right. Small island, you know, but, you know, we're little but we're Talawa, as they say. Translation, we're small, but we're strong, all right? So when I say good evening, I need you to put some bass in it, right? Some strength, I wanna feel it. We're in Garden City, I know it's a little sleepy, but good evening, everyone. All right. Y'all can pass. I see some people in here, all right. I'll be back with you, okay? All right, so make yourselves comfortable. If you wanna get some more drinks next door, feel free. If you want to bring me a drink, feel free. You know, I'm a gin and tonic guy. No, I don't drink. I'm kidding. All right, thank you. I'll be back. Mr. DJ, do you think? That was a joke. Oh man, this is a tough crowd. All right, seriously, how are y'all doing tonight? Y'all ready?
Yay.
All right, one excited gentleman over there who said yay. Who is that? Okay, another one gave me a thumbs up. Mr. Mayor, you don't have to run. You can take it easy. You're the guest of honor. You know? Yeah, you just, you know, the honorees are special. You can saunter, you can walk slowly, whatever it is that you want to do. Good evening again, folks. Like I said, my name is Christopher Williams. For those of you who just joined, you're here for the Big Awards. Big, like I said, stands for Business Innovators and Game Changers. The people we'll be honoring tonight represent that. You know, their outstanding work in the community, their outstanding work as business owners, as entrepreneurs, as leaders, earns them the right to get the accolades they're getting tonight. It's very important you give people their flowers while they're alive, right? Oftentimes, we wait too long. You can clap if you want to clap. I'm not offended. You know, I feel special when I say something that's clapworthy. So So, you know, the gentleman that is really behind this is the man who is responsible, of course, with my mother for me being here. And his name is Dr. Clive Williams. I don't know where he is. He is somewhere around. If anyone sees him, could you have him report to me forthwith, please? You know, it's very important that we thank our sponsors tonight, Furtado Shipping, Queens County Savings Bank, UPS, specifically the UPS store at 22919 Merrick Boulevard in Laurelton, Supreme Auto Body. Derek Lewis is here with his wife. Derek, where are you? All right, Derek, Supreme Auto Body. Now, I got to say something since I called Derek. Okay, so, you know, people have had, unfortunately, you have a car accident, right? Your car gets smashed up. You need some work done. Supreme Auto Body has saved me a few times. Not saying I'm accident prone, you know, no, I drive carefully, but other people don't, you know, because it's, you know, you're the careful driver, it's other people you have to worry about. And, you know, I had a truck veer off the road and totaled my car. Derek brought it back to life. How, I don't know, but he did his thing. So Supreme Auto Body is a great place to go to get body work done if you ever need it done. Car body work, no BBL, all right, car body work. Just want to clear that up, just in case. Eden Home Care Services, another one of our sponsors. Thank you. Where's Eden? All right, now, come on, Eden. You're not making enough noise. I don't hear you. Okay, I think I kind of hear you. One of the guys over there was really quiet. He didn't say anything. I'm not singling him out. The guy with the shirt. That guy. He didn't say anything. Bruce's Patties.
You made the pink shirt.
Is that a pink shirt? I didn't know if it was mauve, taupe, whatever. I don't know. I can't tell colors. You got to stand over this. You're this side here, young man.
Why are you telling me where to stand?
Because you're my father. I can tell you what to do.
Okay.
The older they get, you can tell them what to do. Come closer. Too far. All right. So, Bruce's Patties and Tom Bird Scrap Metal and Junk Removal. Is anybody here from Tom Bird? All right.
Tom Bird.
Is
that's the bird right there.
You're the bird?
Yeah.
So who's Tom?
That's me too.
You're Tom and the bird.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm all together.
You're all together.
Yeah.
All
right.
Wait, does that mean you're two people?
One.
You're one person.
Or two bodies.
You're plural.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not singular,
but plural.
Yeah.
All right. We just do a little jokes here. It's okay. We have fun. All right. What were you going to say, sir?
Stop harassing my
clients. No, I just wanted to understand what was going on. That's all. Is that okay?
Okay. So this lady has a unique business.
Okay.
Unique business model. Unique in the sense that not many women think of out of the box.
Right.
Like opening the kind of business that she has. We know that there's been a sort of upsurge of businesses like that, the
right.
Junk removal business.
Absolutely.
But how many women have thought of that as a business model? How many women are strong enough to really deal with that
as
a business model? And she's a Jamaican woman, a Caribbean woman, resourceful, smart, and we just want to commend you.
Could you please stand so everybody can see you? And what's your name?
Angela.
Yeah. What's your last name, Angela?
Nelson.
Oh, Nelson. Angela Nelson. We applaud you, Angela Nelson.
Thank you.
Right. Definitely.
That's where we're going. Where are you on the program now?
Sir, I'm going to welcome a couple speakers. All right. There are a few people here, a few special guests. Mr. Horace Davis from the Caribbean American Society of New York. Ariel Messam, who is a first in aviation. And Mr. Devin Harris, who is the founding member of the Jamaican National Bobsled Team. You remember that? Who remembers that movie? Who remembers the movie Cool Runnings? You know, feel the rhythm, feel the ride.
He's right here.
Hold on. Y'all not going along with me, so I don't think y'all saw the movie. Feel the rhythm, feel the ride. Get on up. All right. Now you know, okay. So Devin is here. And I can say Devin is my homie. You know what I'm saying? I know Devin, right? We go way back like 8 tracks in a Cadillac, right? Devin, where you at? Where you at? Devin, where you at? Where I hide for boss? All right, so we're gonna have them have
a few words from from these kind people, and then after that we will serve dinner because we want to make sure people are fed, and then we'll have the
right. And if there's a request I want to make, is that people get a chance to dance, right?
Absolutely, that's why I'm here.
And you are in charge of the program, right?
Yes. I don't understand why
so
you're still talking.
So you will not impede why my chances of getting
but you're
to dance.
You're interrupting my program. I don't understand.
You asked me up here.
I just wanted them to see your face.
I can leave.
I just wanted them to see your face. I really didn't expect all of this.
Okay.
Go to your room.
Okay.
All right. No, come back. Can you please tell them about the big awards? And I know you had a couple of words to say. Please say a few words and, you know, I'll step to the side.
So. I'll try to be brief as my mind allows me to.
He's not.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Sorry.
I want to welcome my friend, Dr. Marlene, thank you very much for your continued support. She's not only my friend, but she's my dentist. She takes care of you. You should have a dentist like her.
I do.
I bet you don't have a dentist like my dentist. Dr. Marlene, could you stand, please? We don't want to see who you are. Her practice is in Queens. You can get the information from me. To our sponsors, I really want to thank Furtado Shipping. I don't know where Philip is this evening. He should have been here. But Furtado Shipping has been advertising with us for north of 25 years.
Longer,
right?
Because before we started the magazine, he was with us on radio.
We were on radio, right?
Yep.
Okay. And that's where Furtado Shipping started with us. And they remained with us. And as a sponsor, they are the marquee sponsor. And our other sponsors, as you can see, Eden Home Care. Now, this is a new business in terms of our community. They have been around, all right? But they want to give our community care. We need people who care about us, who look like us, who can feel our pain. And these people at Eden have created that kind of environment, a training environment. They have a school in place. So you all here have family, relatives, right? Tell them that if they want to get into the business of healthcare, talk to Eden Home Care. Talk to me, I'll put you on to them. All right? Round of applause for these great people. Brandon from UPS wasn't able to make it. He has to go to Canada. But he has been a perennial sponsor of our events, and he advertises with us for years in the magazine. So, in his absence, we want to give a round of applause for UPS Store. By the way, just so you know, you would not believe it. This UPS store is located on Merrick Boulevard in Laurelton. It is, in terms of numbers, the highest grossing store in the New York area. The highest grossing store. These guys do business you'd not believe. And part of our community supports what we do. So, let me begin very, if I've not mentioned you at some point, I'm going to get to you this evening. I want to welcome back my friend Bob D'Souza. Bob is a well-known young man in the community, and Bob went through, just like my son did, went through a bout of sickness that kind of took him down, shook him. But he's coming back stronger. So is my son, Chris, coming back stronger than he ever was. I'll tell you about that. But suffice it to say, the big awards came about because we looked at our community and we saw people like you doing things. Some small things, some big things, but you're doing things in the community. You're in business, you're in the professions. You have a store. You are an enterprising community person who just sees a need and helps your neighbors. We look at people like that, Chris and I and my family over the years, and we notice that the people who are getting all the kudos and all the honor and respect and the awards are people who are well known. The same people are recycled over and over again. They're the ones who are always being publicized and being. So we said to ourselves, look, There is no community that respects and honors being identified and recognized by anyone else but their own community. In other words, no matter how you are loved by other people, in deep in your heart, there's a yearning that your people will accept you, that your own people that you grew up with, your own people that you went to school with, do business with, will honor you. And there's an old saying that a prophet has no honor in his own country, right? You know that statement, right? A prophet has no honor in his own country. And for too long, right, we have behaved like that. Now, we wanted to change that paradigm. We want to say that our people, the words of Garvey, it should resonate in our minds every time. How many people here are familiar with Marcus Garvey? If you're familiar with his teachings, one of the things he said that was most profound, we must canonize our own saints, create our own martyrs, black men and women who have made their distinct contributions to our racial history. Garvey couldn't have said it any better. And we should be doing that. And we decided that we wanted to do that. And I said to Chris, says, look, After we brainstormed, I said, we want to really lift up our people. We want Where It's At to be the platform on which our people stand. And I came up with a couple names, and he says, Dad, yeah, nice and good. You're good at this, but let me take a shot at it. And he came up with the big concept, business innovators and game changers. And the acronym is BIG. And I said it, I called a couple of friends of mine, and I mentioned, and they poo-pooed it. They didn't like the idea of BIG. Says it sounds ordinary. And, you know, but I believed that my son had an idea whose time had come. And I stuck with it, and we adopted the name, the BIG Awards. Thank you, Chris. And so, you are going to be tonight the recipients of the BIG Award. Now, you might consider this a wonderful thing, and you might be thankful and grateful for it, but I tell you, you're going to even be more thankful in another 10 or 15 years, because we are going to take this nationally. We're going to make sure that our people are recognized. Sure, we don't want to be like Hollywood. We want to be solid, hardworking people who make a contribution to our communities. And I believe that as long as we have the support, as we now have from our community, we'll continue to build and make sure that the BIG Awards satisfies at least part of the important work of recognizing those people in our community who are doing something worthwhile. Let me now stop and introduce my son is going to be master of ceremonies for the evening, Christopher Williams. I will tell you, he unequivocally has my endorsement as a man and as a human being. I have not, and I respect and love my father. I thought my father was the strongest, most resilient human being I had ever seen. However, if you have any idea what my son has been through in the last 5 or so years, a little bit more than that, you would not believe that he's standing there right now with all the gusto and all the energy and all the feistiness and so forth that he has. But I respect him to the ground he walks on because of his toughness. This guy never complained. He never once called me and said, Dad, you know, I can't. Dad, I don't feel like. Dad, I don't know what to do. No. This man took his medicine. Literally and figuratively took his medicine, right? And he weathered the storm, continues to weather the storm. So look, I'm not going to eulogize you when you're gone, right? I'm speaking now of who you are, what you represent to me. You're a big man.
Somebody cutting onions in here?
I wish I could give you a big award.
Hey, listen, that was big. That was big.
That's for other folks.
Seriously, who's cutting onions?
I welcome you this evening, folks. I welcome you to this event. And the ethos that we practice here is that you get to know each other. Please, shake hands, make friends, pass your cards, share your phone numbers, because we need to continue doing business with each other. We must, or else we will not survive. So let this be part of the beginning of us getting together. Forget all the false history that has been sold. Believe you me, a bill of goods. What they're saying about black folks not being able to work together, all lies. If it were true, we would not be in business today.
That's a fact.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So, it's not true. Let's get it together. Thank you for coming, and we're going to have a good time.
Yes, we are. Thank you, sir. Thank you. There are a couple people I want to welcome up, and bear with me. So, it's now 8:05. We're going to serve dinner soon, all right? Because I want to make sure you guys eat. So you have a great appetite, you're ready to dance. And of course, for the people who are going to be honored, I want you to be able to clap in your hands. You have the energy to clap to celebrate them, all right? So we're going to be very quick. I want to welcome up Mr. Horace Davis, the founder and current president of the Caribbean American Society of New York. He created a nonprofit organization with the goal of improving the social, educational, and economic status of its members through a focus on educational initiatives, charitable giving, cultural events, and political involvement. Mr. Davis, please.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Round of applause for Chris and Mr. Clyde, please. So, as was mentioned, my name is Horace Davis. And, you know, when you get in front of a group, you want to get a sense of who's in the room. So I'm going to ask just a couple questions just so I can understand a little bit. Who do we have in this room who's from Jamaica? Is Jamaica represented?
Yay!
Excellent. And who do we have in this room from the Dominican Republic?
None. Crickets. Nobody.
What? Nobody. No? Okay. All right. So,
Haiti. You gotta call Haiti. You can't leave
out
Haiti.
No. I'm gonna leave it there because I think that it speaks to the message as to why the Caribbean American Society of New York is founded. The overarching mission of this organization is to build and cultivate a stronger sense of pride within the Caribbean community, breaking down the silos that exist between our islands, because together we're just so much stronger. And I don't want to be long-winded, but I'm going to share a real quick story, I think, that speaks to the message as to why we need to be together. About a month or so, I was at a barbecue, and I was introduced to this gentleman who has political ambitions of, you know, all the way up to the governor in New York State. And he gave me his business card, and I accepted his business card, and we started having a conversation about Kasoni and what it's about. The fact that the pillars that we stand on, business, education with a focus on STEM, we want our kids to be educated, but we want that education to be aligned with the careers of the future. Networking and engaging in policy and so forth. So after he gave me my card and I talked to him about us coming together as a community and how we were gonna build, not only in New York City and New York State, you wouldn't believe what he did. He took back his card from me. Can you imagine that? He took back his card from me. Why? Because it didn't have his personal email and personal cell phone number. Okay? I say that to say the folks that are out there recognize how powerful we can be when we come together as a community, one strong Caribbean community. I might have been a little facetious when I asked the question, but note that in New York City, five of the top nine immigrant countries have one thing in common. They're Caribbean islands. And the number one immigrant island in New York City is the Dominican Republic. Now, as an engineer, I look at things oftentimes in terms of math, and think about that. If five of the top nine immigrant countries or Caribbean islands, and we come together as one, the influence that we can and should have would just be incredible. And so with that, I think I've just wanted to leave that thought in your minds, because that is what we're doing and where we're really looking to take this organization. To have a Caribbean community that goes beyond any one island and celebrate our culture. Okay? Thank you so much for listening.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, thank you. Make sure you check out the website is casony.org. Is that correct?
Yes.
CASONY.org. And please, you know, like my dad said, network, get to know each other. Everybody in this room is doing something outstanding. So you should all get to know each other, exchange information. That's why we do this. That's why we continue to do this. The next person I'd like to bring up is a young lady who I've known before she was born. So knew her when she was in the room, in the womb, Miss Ariel Messon. Now, Ariel is a first in aviation. All right. She's the youngest Black female certified private pilot in New York. She attended and graduated from Aviation Career and Technical Education High School in Queens. And she earned both her high school diploma and her certification as an aircraft power plant technician, all while playing varsity basketball? You did all of that? Come on, you gotta give it up. I mean, I haven't done that. And I'm 50.
Let me also say, folks, that we discovered Ariel very early. She was honored by us about 5-6 years ago.
Yeah, yeah.
As one of the young, up-and-coming young women in this community. So we're very proud of Ariel. Congratulations.
Yes. Come inside.
God is good, amen?
Amen.
How you guys doing tonight?
Great.
So, as he said, my name is Ariel Messon. I am now 18 years old and the youngest Black female certified here in New York. So, I received my private pilot's license in July of this year. And one thing I realized is that, you know, you don't see people like me up in the cockpit. And I'd say the biggest thing for that is exposure. Like, why aren't there more young females out here flying airplanes? That's because we're not exposed to it. And there, my brother, Anthony Messam, who he's not here today, but he started a nonprofit organization called Level Up and Take Off. And our mission with this organization is to promote and bring out the exposure of aviation to people like me. So because a lot of the small airplane activities, it happens out in Long Island, and we want to bring what's out there here into the city so that people like me can say, oh, hey, yeah, I can fly too. And I document everything I do on social media, and I've gotten numerous comments and outreach, and I'm proud to say that I am a mentor to three upcoming young females who will be pilots soon. Yeah, I also want to say thanks to my mom, who helped me in times where I didn't think I would finish or think that it would be possible. And I also want to say thank you to my brother, Andre, who's here today. helped me every step of the way. He's the one that actually told me about a program that I went to in Minnesota, where I took my first flight at 14 years old. And I came back here to New York, high school, and then finished my certification for my airplane and power plant license and my power plant license. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ariel. You know, it's almost like Ariel and her brother are my kids. I literally have known both of them before they were born. I knew when they came. I was there, and seeing this now, it's just a proud moment. Congratulations again. Please put your hands together again. Thank you. You know, something like that is, you know, that kind of story is amazing, and it should resonate with everyone. So if you have children, grandchildren, your friends have children, you know, make sure you connect with her and get them involved. Just expose them to it. Even if they don't pursue it now, but later on they may have an interest. These are the kinds of things we want to get involved in. Tonight you're going to meet people who are architects, restaurateurs, lawyers, you know, people who are doing amazing things, you know, doctors, you know, it's just, this is what this is about. It's about options. It's about opening our eyes up to the opportunities, the plethora of opportunities that exist. The next person I want to welcome up is Mr. Devin Harris, who, like I said, is a founding member of the Jamaican National Bobsled Team, an Olympian and retired military officer. He's a first in bobsledding. Mr. Devin Harris. Feel the rhythm. Feel the ride. Sir.
Good morning.
You say good morning.
Yes, I'm just checking to see that everybody's awake. Good morning. It's great to be here with you in a room full of beautiful looking people like Chris. I want to be like you guys when I grow up, you know. May have to lose a few pounds, but it's all good. As Chris mentioned, I'm an original member of the Jamaica bobsled team, former captain of the Jamaica Defense Force. These days, I'm a motivational speaker. So whenever I get the mic, Chris, you know it's an hour or so. So.
Oh, no. I'll tackle you.
But I'm Jamaican, so I know, so you know, for standing between people and them food. So I'm just want to spend some time just to bring greetings. As I said, it's wonderful to be here. Congratulations to Clive and Chris, WhatsApp, where it's at for the big awards. This is indeed a big deal, you know. Business innovators, game changers, that's what all of you guys are. And as a member of the Jamaica bobsled team, I understand what it is to be in a space where you are being innovative, where you're being a game changer. And so being here in a room with all these innovators and these game changers kind of send chills up my spine. So congratulations on all the work that you have done, not just in terms of moving your purpose forward personally, but what you're doing in the community as well. Because in the end, what matters is not so much what we do for ourselves, but how we inspire others, how we allow others to go seek their purpose to live in a big way. So this is a big deal. I want you to have a big fun and make some big connections this evening. Thank you so much.
One more big. A big round of applause. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Pleasure seeing you, man. Folks, you ready to eat?
Yeah.
No, you're not ready to eat. You know, I don't think you want to eat. It's okay. You know, earlier, Mr. Davis, when he spoke, asked how many Jamaicans were here. We know the Jamaicans are here. You guys go everywhere. I'm tired of seeing you now. I'm Jamaican. I can say that. I don't care. Haitians. Where are my Haitians at? Come on now. I know y'all can do better than that. Where are my Haitians at? All right. That's what I'm talking about. I like to see that because I'm Jamaican, yes, but I feel Haitian by association. You know, I feel like y'all accepted me into the club. You know, ça passe. Qui j'en dirais? Ah, you see, I know a little something. I'm a little vagabond, you know. I've been called, what's the word I always say, babe? There's something I call you all the time. I don't know. Okay, I can't use that word you say. Okay, sorry. Yes, sir?
Who introduced you to the Haitian culture?
Who introduced me to the Haitian culture?
Right.
You did.
How did I do that?
Our next door neighbors?
No.
I don't know.
Remember when I took you out of school, Jamaica High School?
No, but we go back from Jamaica, right?
Oh, yeah, from
yeah,
Jamaica.
Yeah. But here, yes.
And what happened?
We marched across the bridge.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. So that was during the time, and this is, you know, this is, we know the culture, right? We know what's going on in this country. I don't need that mic. That was during the time when America had this nonsense going, not nonsense, this racism, associating AIDS. Oh, yeah, they still have it, but I'm just talking about that particular time, because there's tons of times when they were attributing HIV AIDS to Haitians and sub-Saharan Africans. So we marched with a large contingent of people across the Brooklyn Bridge, I believe, and I was in school, right? Say that again? We shook the bridge. Yes, we did. Yes, we did. And my dad took me out of school for that because he's always taught me the importance of activism, the importance of fighting for what we believe in. And I've never stopped doing that. And I still do that to this day. So we should continue to do that. We're here, Jamaicans, Haitians, Trinidadians, we're all here. Where my people from Trinidad at? Where Trinidad at? My Trini, to the board, okay? All right, good. To the board. All right, so we're gonna get started. We're gonna get some eats. So what I'm gonna do is, are we ready, Lee?
Yeah.
Lee, we're ready? I didn't hear Lee shout yes, but anyway, he's ready. I know he's ready because he told me you would be. So we're gonna start.
We're gonna start together. We got the
just the way
for them, because I've been watching them since they've been out here. I can't do it. Listen, I cannot do that. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to fake it. I cannot do. Please tell me your name, sir.
Fred,
and can I take your class?
Fred Astaire.
Huh? Tony and Patty Kelly. All right, so I'm your new pupil. Yes. No, well, teach me. All right, so I'm very serious. Because I'm just saying, I can't do that. Brothers, are there any brothers who can do that? Raise your hand if you can do it. And tell the truth. Because I'll let the DJ put something on right now. And test you out. I'm saying, if you can do that, I mean, that's what you call sweeping a lady off her feet. All right? I mean, okay, I'm just saying, I'm excited. So we're gonna get started with our program very, very soon. I wanted to bring up a gentleman here, a brother, Dornell Peters, to continue to entertain you a little bit while you finish eating. Again, thank you all for joining us. I wanna say a special, special, special shout out to Miss Claudette Powell from the Jamaica Nurse Group of New York, Jamaica Diaspora Health Sector, Northeast USA. Wave your hand. Okay, I see you. All right. Mr. Dornell Peters, please step forward. This brother is a vocalist. He has been singing for quite some time. I taught him everything he knows. You know, you see how he's coordinating right there? He got the mushroom. You got the mushroom belt too? Oh, no. Okay, you got the Gucci. All right, he's Gucci. Shh, my brother. Come on, come around here, man. I mean, you're not new to this, you're true to this. So, this is all you. All right.
All right.
All right.
Good evening, everybody. Everybody all right?
Yeah.
All right. Selector.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right.
I'm so in love with you. Whatever you want to do. It's all right with me, yeah. 'Cause you make me feel so brand new. And I want to spend my life with you. Let me say things, baby. Since we've been together, oh, loving you forever is what I need. Let me be the one you come running to. Times are good.
let's stay together.
All right.
Try a little something. You taught me good, man. You taught me well. Yeah, man.
Okay. Can I give you a piece of something else?
Yeah. Used to spend my nights out in the ballroom. Liquor was the only love I know. But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom and brought me back from being too far gone. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. And honey, I stay strong on your love all the time. Yeah. You ready now?
Listen, I need a few more minutes, so you gotta give me something else.
What is God up about Jesus? You see, yo?
This is called filling time, brother. Filling time. You know, when you in Hollywood, you know, they put you behind a curtain and all that, but. You know, yeah. We're black. We do it different.
Yeah. We do. We just improvise. Yeah. You still do what you do, and you're fiddling through the papers
All right.
Yes. What do you think? Hello, everybody. Once again, obviously, I have to do something else because my brother's still working. You know what I mean? So, let me see. I was born by the river in a little tent. And roll just like the river I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. All right. You ready now?
I'm ready. I've been ready. You know, I was ready for you.
You see, you can't take people nowhere. Thank you very much once again. You've been lovely.
My brother.
All right.
Thank you, man. Thank you. So, folks, I do singing lessons. I take PayPal, Zelle, Cash App. And you'll be able to sing like him after I'm done with you. I don't understand why y'all laughing like this is a joke. I'm not here to do stand-up. It's a fact. I can sing. Y'all want to hear me sing? Yeah. Wrote a song. I'm gonna get it right now. Hold on. Woo! Hold on. Somebody bring me a glass of water. No, I'm just kidding. Listen, I'm not gonna sing. We're going to start presenting our awards to our amazing, amazing honorees. Are you all ready?
Yeah.
I heard no. I heard yes. Are y'all ready?
Yes.
Are y'all ready?
Yes.
To my Haitian brothers and sisters over here, y'all ready?
Yeah!
They louder than all y'all. See what I'm talking about? That's why I rep Haiti all day, every day. Sac passé! Sac passé! Sac passé! All right, you don't know nothing about it. Tell you, let me see if my Jamaicans can put a little, you know, stank on it, as they say. Wagwan! Y'all not even like unified. Like, how y'all gonna let? Look, it's how many people? Okay, it's two tables, all right? And it's all y'all. I said, Wagwan, nah. What? Oh, you don't got you, you're Jamaicans? Nah, that's unacceptable. Listen, Dad, I'm trading my passport in for Haiti. You know what I'm saying? This is it. I'm done. No, seriously. So, in the spirit of Jamaica, since we're talking about Jamaica, there's a brother here by the name of Donovan Wilson, who is the president of the Union of Jamaican Alumni Association, USA, and the immediate past president of St. Elizabeth Technical High School, otherwise known as STETS Alumni Association, USA. He's also a corporate transportation professional, a tax professional, who's also registered with the Internal Revenue Service and New York State for over 15 years. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. Donovan Wilson, our first big honoree of the evening. I have Mr. Clive Williams walking up. You know, I know he's got something. He's working on something. Mr. Wilson, sir, you've been doing a lot of great work in the community. We've seen you. We see you. All right. We continue to see you. We recognize you. And, you know, this moment is your moment. So thank you very much. Appreciate it. I have Mr. Williams here, who I know has something to say.
Yeah, I'm inviting Mr. Peters and Jackie Peters, founders of this incredible company, Eden Home Care Services, to present this award. In addition to your big award, Donovan, we have a special congressional recognition award for you as well. And I'm going to ask Jackie Peters to present that to you. And Annette, where are you? Still eating? Mr. Peters, have you started eating yet, Mr. Peters?
Annette is coming. She's running.
If you're eating, could you come on up, Mr. Peters? Yes, absolutely. There are three Peters here. Yeah, and this is the gentleman that I told you must be related to. He is the bank manager, and Mr. Peters, I want you to introduce yourself.
Thank you, Doc. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Adrian Peters. I'm a branch manager with New York Community Bank. I've been with the bank over 25 years. Actually, some of you might know us as Roslyn Savings Bank.
Sorry, that's me.
In Queens, we're Queens County Savings Bank. But anyway, you see that NYCB logo, that's us. As a matter of fact, come the end of this year, we will be changing our brand because we recently acquired Flagstar Bank and earlier on this year, Signature Bank. So we're changing our brand going forward from January of 2024. We'll be known as Flagstar. Yeah. So thank you very much, Doc, for having us here. Appreciate everything that you do for the community. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Don't go anywhere. I know you want to eat. A big round of applause. You are now officially sponsors of the big awards, and we've been working with you now for before the pandemic, right? And finally, you've come on board, and we thank you for being on board with us. I want you to do an award, but before that, let us have the other Peters, who I think, Adrian, I think you need to talk to this gentleman, because you're both from the same part of the world, and you need to talk. All right. And the other young man who did the amazing singing, Donnell, he's also Peters, but he spells his Peters P-I-E-T-E-R-S, which you know is Dutch, right? So that's an interesting, this is how we are as Caribbean folk. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Donovan Wilson, now let me warn you folks, this award is heavy. All right, it's heavy. So, Donovan, could you give that to Mr. Peters and Donovan? Okay. All right, it's your time, folks.
Mr. Williams, you can step in the picture when you're done so we can get a picture with everyone. With
group shot.
Put your lady in the middle. Peter, put your wife in the middle.
Go ahead. You gotta get the photography thing happening, all right? Thank you very much, Mr. Wilson. Mr. Peters. Okay.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, let me say thanks to Chris
and to Clive for giving me this award. I see this as an award for the Union of Jamaica Alumni Associations, which represents 65 alumni groups. Some time ago, you may have heard that we were trying to raise funds to send a Jamaica team to compete in robotics in Singapore, and that we were looking at a very tall order because we needed to raise almost $100,000. I am happy to tell you all that the team will be leaving next week, Wednesday, to go to Singapore, thanks to the efforts of so many people, Jamaicans and otherwise. So once again, thank you.
Thank you, sir. That's fantastic news. Congratulations again, Mr. Donovan Wilson of the Union of Jamaica Alumni Association. Next up, our next honoree is Dr. Nicole Grimes. All right. Yes, you can say, woo, whoever said that. Everybody can say it, please. Woo! Dr. Grimes is an award-winning author, STEM educator, leadership consultant, and founder of Carabiz Network since 2019. Her 20-year career in education and her love of Caribbean culture served as a seedbed to start CBN, which is Carabiz Network, a community dedicated to amplifying Caribbean talent and entrepreneurs. And she hails from none other than the twin island of Trinidad and Tobago. So please put your hands together for Dr. Nicole Grimes. You can step over this way, please, Ms. Grimes. Gotta have the paparazzi do their thing, you know what I mean? These are pictures which you will have, okay? So, you know, we gotta make sure we commemorate the moment. Okay. Go ahead, Aris. Thank you very much. Nicole, if you'd like to say, I know you may want to say a couple of words. Yeah, I put you on the spot. I know.
I know. I was not informed that I had to speak.
You didn't have to speak. But you have to speak because you represent Trinidad. Come on now.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Thank you so much for this wonderful honor for me. When Chris reached out and informed me, I kind of felt uncomfortable. I'm like, I just feel like I'm in the beginning of a second career, my new journey, as an entrepreneur. I previously served 20 years as an educator, university professor, and high school principal in New York. And I left after 20 years to kind of figure out what I wanted to do in my life. And I'm just so honored to be in this space leading a brand that's focused on amplifying Caribbean talent, Caribbean voices. And I'm just really excited to continue my journey representing us, we, everywhere we go really well. And I just look forward to serving everyone in this room, and I have big shoes to fill with the other honorees, and I'm grateful, so thank you.
See, you're always ready, because I know you're always ready. Why? Because it comes from Trinidad and Tobago. Yeah, he said yeah. One guy said yeah. Huh? You're the only one? No, there's more of you. I heard the woo. Next up. Where my Asian people at? Nah, y'all sound like you the itis is set in. It's not as exuberant as it was earlier. So we're going to try this again. Where my Asian massive? Now I hear you. Now I hear you. So next up is a brother who goes by the name of Fred Raphael. Now, Fred is a remarkable entrepreneur who has demonstrated his ability to seamlessly integrate his passion for food, culture, finance, and art into his businesses and community efforts. As an immigrant to the United States from none other than Haiti, he has a unique perspective on the importance of education and has made it a priority to share his knowledge and experience with others. Through his two restaurants, First Republic and Rebel, Raphael has created spaces where people can come together to enjoy great food, music, and culture. Put your hands together, please, for Mr. Fred Raphael. I mean, you know, the brother is sharp. You see the glasses? You see the tux, right? You see the bow tie? Now, look, I gotta come around for this. Look at this. I touch his arms, they're like guns. You know, when I grew up, man. Look at his shoes. You see, this is what I'm talking about. Like, you gotta come with it. I'm Haitian. I love my Jamaican people, but I'm Haitian tonight. I feel it. Congratulations, brother.
Thank you.
All right, cool. Who's, am I presenting it? I mean, cause since I'm here, you're getting somebody, okay. We're gonna have to have a talk afterwards, backstage, cause, I mean, you know, I paid you yesterday, so you got paid. I don't understand what's going on.
Slowing down.
You're slowing down? Okay, all right. And are you gonna be doing the honors? Okay, all right, let me step out of the way. Because you're definitely more photographic than me.
This is a certificate of special congressional recognition presented to Fred Raphael in recognition of outstanding and invaluable service to the community.
Thank you very much, Dr. Miller. Dr. Carol Miller, I appreciate you. All right. And Fred, that award is heavy, but you know, you work out, so you can lift that. Probably with your pinky, you know. There you go. It's all you.
I just wanted to say Zach Bassett, you know.
That's all you want to say? Come on, man.
No, I do want to say Zach Bassett, but I want to say thank you to all that came out tonight. Tonight is such a beautiful and wonderful night. I couldn't leave the stage without saying thank you to my family, to my wife, to my friends, to my business partner, which is here tonight. Without her, none of this would be possible. We do own two restaurants and have different other ventures. And she's my Jamaican counterpart. As you know, Haiti and Jamaica has a wonderful relationship,
yes,
by the way.
Yes, from Bookman to Toussaint Louverture, working together.
Since 1791, yes. So I'm extremely excited to be here tonight. My wife is here in attendance, so I want to thank her for the support throughout the years. You know, whenever you see a young man running around getting things done, there's someone at home that's holding the burden of supporting the kids, supporting the family. So I'm so grateful that she's able to be here tonight as well. So thank you. It's a true blessing. Thank you to my mother-in-law, my father-in-law. My two brothers are here. My brothers are here. Mr. Kirvin the Comics, which is one of my true friends. I call him another mother, a brother from another mother. That's here. But before I do leave, I do want to thank my mom for being here tonight. I truly want to say thank you to her. I'll say it in Creole, so Shansi, she doesn't understand English, but I want to say merci. Pour tout ce qu'elle fait pour moi, pour tout ce qu'elle y est, pour tout ce qu'elle apprend moi. Without her, this would not be possible. I left Haiti 13 years when I was 13 and came here. This woman, I am now learning to appreciate the woman she was or she is, because I spent a lot of time with my dad before he passed. And when you kind of hear the stories of what she endured as a woman, walking 13, 15 hours to take you to the hospital to wash your clothes, that gave me an appreciation. And I don't know words or anyhow to thank her, except to say that I truly love you and I appreciate you, and I don't know how to repay you, but the days that I get to appreciate you, I thank God for the blessing. So thank you, Lord.
Thank you so much, brother. Thank you. Check, one, two, am I on? Check 1, 2, 1, 2. Can you hear me, folks? Can you hear me? Yes. Thank you so much, Fred. And I want to say something very important. Fred is someone who, you know, pays it forward because he has an event that he's been doing called Creole Image Honors. And he's always prioritized giving people their flowers. So I'm glad to see him get his and continue to get his. Our next honoree is no stranger to structure, whether that be in that of a building or it be in terms of organization. Ibrahim Greenwich, RA, which stands for Registered Architect, also co-founded Bolt Architecture in 2012 and serves as the managing partner. In his decade of experience, Ibrahim has designed more than $150 million worth of building construction. In 2017, he was appointed to serve as president of the New York Coalition of Black Architects. A winner of the 2015 Jemani Stewart Recognition Award, his designs have been featured in the UN's Remembering Slavery exhibit and the Center for Architecture's Say It Loud, Distinguished Black Designers of Nicoba Noma. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hand together for registered architect Ibrahim Greenwich. Now, I emphasize the registered architect because those of you who know there are not many black architects. They assign a number to them, okay, because they're not that many. That's you know, one of these things that we want to change, and Ibrahim works to change that. Presenting the award will be Miss Claudette Powell of Jamaica Nurse Group of New York. Please step over on this side, please, to my right. Thank you. As you see, in addition to the awards, everyone is receiving a citation from Congresswoman Yvette Clark's office. I would like to thank you all for your continued patience as we do this. Please feel free to come up and take photos of your loved ones who are receiving their honors.
Certificate of Special Congressional Recognition presented to Ibrahim Greenwich in recognition of outstanding and invaluable service to the community, Saturday, September 30th, 2023, from Congresswoman Yvette D. Clark.
Thank you. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Sound a little dead, but you know, we here. Thank you. What can I start with? Thanks to my wife. Thanks to my mom and dad. Thanks to where it's at. Thanks to Mr. Williams and Christopher. Appreciate you and all the work you've been doing with the community. Thank you. Thank you to all for coming out.
Oh, you did a true Russell Simmons speech. Thank you, my brother. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate you.
Appreciate you.
Yes. Yes, sir. Thank you.
It is heavy.
It is heavy. You've been working out. You know, we're in the park on a regular. Well, I've been missing the park lately. I got to get back to it.
I'll see you next week.
Yeah, I'll be there next week, next Saturday, bright and early. Our next honoree was born in Jamaica, West Indies, and immigrated to the USA in the 1970s after completing high school at the renowned Kingston College. Now, folks, hold on. I'm going to emphasize this. The renowned Kingston College, for my non-Jamaicans, I'll explain it to you. You know, Jamaicans, we have this thing about schools, right? I went to the best school in Jamaica, Kingston College. Fortis cadere sedere non potest, the brave may fall but never yield. This man behind me.
Mirandum, this man, ludum, stratum, kiss mortalibus.
It sounds like you're speaking in tongues, brother. Yeah. This gentleman here went to some school called Calabar.
I'm the lion.
Calabar.
I'm the lion.
They call themselves Rabelax. I mean, what is that? They go back ways to come forward. Like, you know, it just doesn't work. We don't need to do all of that. All right, so we're going to get into it. See, okay, another Calabar guy. Get out of here.
The DJ
who has been feedback.
Entertaining you all feedback. Evening feedback. Went to Calabar.
Right.
My DJ,
Yes.
Can I hear you?
So
say Calabar.
61 Radio is the greatest school on the planet. Rabalak till the casket lock.
Rabalak till the casket lock. Okay. I see the puzzled look on your faces. Could you come over here, please?
For those of you who don't know the Jamaican culture in terms of high school pride, we'll explain it to you later.
Mr. James Haynes, please join us up here. Please, as an accomplished gentleman from Kingston College, who attended City College of New York and earned a BSc degree and received his master's degree from Adelphi University, Mr. James Haynes.
Certificate of Special Congressional Recognition presented to James Haynes in recognition of outstanding and invaluable service to the community. Congratulations, sir. My wife of 52 years is going to be presenting your award.
Thank you.
It's my mother. That's my mother.
This is Michelle.
That's my mama. It should be noted that Mr. Haynes is the founder since 2012 and president and CEO of the Jajeri Foundation, a not-for-profit that is named in memory of his father, the late Jerome Haynes, OD, affectionately known as Jajeri in the music world.
Have you ever heard about the Scatolites?
Yes.
Okay, his father was a premier member of that incredible band, the Scatolites. And this man has written a book on the history of his father and the Scatolites. And so we salute you, my friend.
Thank you so much.
Please support the book. It's called Jajeri, Legacy of an Original Scatolite.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. I am so humble, honored, delighted to receive this award. Whenever you receive something from your own, it make it so significant. And Clive, Chris, and the entire Where It's At, I am deeply, words cannot describe my feeling right now, but I'm deeply honored for this award. You know, I consider this also coming full circle. This is 10 years that the Jajeri Organization Foundation will be providing scholarship to students, primarily in Jamaica. We, over the 10 years, we have awarded 30 scholarships to students who attend Edlamandi College of the Visual and Performing Arts. In order to be eligible for the Jajeri Foundation Scholarship, the student must be pursuing a bachelor's degree in music, of course, because of my father. I know my father is looking down because in growing up in Jamaica, there are two things that were important to my father: youth development and education. And that's the reason why this foundation was founded. Also, I cannot accept this award and not mention my wife. My wife and I, on Independent Day, August 6th, that's Jamaica Independent Day. Well, this year, we got married on Independent Day, on August 6th, but we got married in 1983. Young college kid. So we've been married for 40 years. Wow. Go on. Also, my mom is not here, she's in Florida, but also I want to send good vibration to my mom. And it's so nice to receive something, recognition, something that you have a passion doing it. I mean, I love what I do. 9 to 5 for me, This is 24/7 because I enjoy so much. Giving back, make a difference in the life of others, touching the life, particularly of young people. And lastly, when I talk about scholarship, the scholarship that we awarded to 30 students, each of those scholarships value $1,000. We also have donated, we donated 20 new computers to elementary, middle school, and high school in Jamaica. This year, we're gonna be donating 20 new computers to Boys Town All-Age School to help them develop their computer lab. So we are very proud of that. So thank you very much, and thank you for coming and be a part of this day, because you certainly, my day has been very special. And I want to, again, just say thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Haynes. Thank you very much. Our next honoree is a quintessential entrepreneur with several business ventures under her belt, which includes a restaurant and wine store, as well as real estate investments in New York, New Jersey, and Atlanta. The Jamaican-born, Brooklyn-bred entrepreneur is most noted, however, as owner and CEO of True Hair Company and the product brand True Indian Hair. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Ms. Karen Mitchell. I heard somebody say, go, Karen. All right. We see you, Karen. We see you. If you want to come over this side to get a better shot, please,
Karen.
Please, Peter, come around this way.
Come right on over.
Go around, go behind, go behind.
And again, the special congressional recognition certificate presented to Karen Mitchell. Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you so much. Thank you,
Karen Mitchell. And let me tell you, this is a one woman dynamo. I mean, I just met Karen not too long ago, just watching her operate. And I must confess, Bev, I thank you very much for the introduction. This is what I mean by people connecting people. You never know what can result from it. And making this acquaintance is just one of the best things that has ever happened to us. We're going to be doing business in the future. She's going to be doing business with many of you. This lady has put a number of young women in business by virtue of what she does. She is amazing what she does. This is a real entrepreneur. No playing. All right. Congratulations.
I'm gonna do a Russell Simmons. Thank you, God bless you, good night. I'm kidding. no, really, thank you guys. This is really a beautiful, beautiful event, beautiful people. I'm truly blessed to be here. I've been an entrepreneur for almost 20 years. I mean, I know I look 16, but yeah, almost 20 years. I started my company basically as a hustle, and with three stores here in New York and online store. It's allowed me to do the restaurant lounge. It's allowed me to open a wine store. So I've been blessed to be an entrepreneur, and I've also been blessed to give back to others. And that's a part of my platform and making sure others behind me are coming up and are just learning. I mean, I am the product of a cashew seller, my mom, who's no longer with us, and I wish she was, because my mom was one of those women who sold cashews in Jamaica that come to your car window and sold cashews. And I am the product of that woman, and she was the first entrepreneur I knew. So I've always said that. So, you know, it's really a blessing to be here, to be amongst you people, amazing game changers, innovators. You know, oftentimes we as entrepreneurs have this imposter syndrome where we really don't think we belong or we even are where we're at. And it's taken me a while to really understand my value to my community. And I really like hold that to my heart. And now I'm just so happy to give back and to really be involved in the community. So thank you, Dr. Cloud, thank you so much. Annette, Chris, I really appreciate you guys.
Thank you.
I don't want you to drop it.
Drop it, mom. It's strong. Puncher girl.
Thank you so much. Folks, you awake? You still awake? Because I don't know, you sounded kind of sleepy. All right, we have a few more honorees because we got to pay tribute. We got to make sure. So just a few more, and then you guys will get to dance, have some more drinks, have a good time. Excuse me, that's very important to me. Now, our next honoree was born on the beautiful island nation of Jamaica, West Indies, in the tranquil parish of Portland. He's the son of Leroy V. Graham, who was born in Santiago, Cuba, worked for the Jamaica Daily Gleaner, and started the first Caribbean American newspaper publication in the United States in 1972. His mother, Dorothy Lingard, is from Durham, Portland, Jamaica. Leroy migrated to the United States on April 30th, 1971, and he's proud of his Jamaican-Cuban heritage. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Leroy Graham Jr. Come on, you can do better than that. Come on. As he slow walks to the stage, I see you in your signature hat there, my brother. And next up, we have Mr. Williams coming here with Georgia to present the citation and the award. Now, I should tell you that Mr. Graham is also the founder of an organization called True Tribute Foundation, which is also a nonprofit, does a lot of work with music as well. And so it's very important that you get to know this brother as well. So throughout the course of the night, there are a lot of great people for you to continue to network with.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'd first like to thank Mr. Williams, Clive, and Chris, and your wonderful staff for selecting me, giving me this recognition tonight. Also, I want to say thank you to my wife, Carlene. Love you, dear. My cousin, Alfredo, and his wife. I started True Tribute Organization, going on 10 years now. And it's from I got that passion for, you know, Jamaican history from my father, Daddy. I have to give thanks to the ancestors, you know, where I always have to do that. My father was a Garveyite, and he taught me to also be a Garveyite. And in that doing, Marcus Garvey told us that a people without knowledge of your history, origin and culture is like a tree without root. And one of the things that I don't hear us do often enough is give thanks first to the Almighty and our ancestors, because we wouldn't have the privilege of being here right now without their sacrifice. And that's one of the reasons why I formed True Tribute Organization. It was based on my relationship with some of the pioneers in the music business, the Roland Alfonsos, the Cox and Dodds. And from that, I created True Tribute Organization, which is to actually pay respect to those individuals while they're alive, and not when they're gone. But at the same time, as an educator, I'll make it short, as an educator with what's going on with Black history in the schools, it's very important that we control the narrative of our history, and we teach that to our children. Because although the tree will have the root, how we nourish it is very important. And if we don't first teach them about the individuals that have made those sacrifices for them to be here, then that sense of identity and that sense of purpose will not be there. I'm all for the STEM and the STEAM, yes, but we must teach them to be producers, not just consumers. And it starts with them knowing who they are. So again, I want to thank you very much. Peace and blessings to everyone. And I want to thank the organization very much, Mr. Williams. I've known you over the years, and you have always been true to what you do. And I greatly appreciate it. Again, I thank my wife, who I love dearly. Right, she has always been there. And my cousin, Alfredo, thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you, Mr. Graham. Our next honoree, okay, you're taking pictures, you finished, you good? Okay, thank you. Our next honoree is known for many things. But one of the things that I would say a lot of people may know her for now is the fact that she opened the Caribbean restaurant, Dunn's River Lounge. In 2004, leveraging her former expertise as VP of marketing for a multi-billion dollar food company, Nala Royale Holder. When the pandemic hit, Nala repositioned the brand and doubled her sales, generating two additional income streams, a takeout and delivery business and a competitive catering business, all under the same 1,100 square feet. What began as a hobby is now a formidable business for the past 19 years. Dunn's River Lounge has an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau and has been featured in Newsday, on Channel 12 News, at the New York Islanders game, embodying the Jamaican saying, "We're little but we're talawa." And of course, she was also featured on the cover of Where It's At magazine. You left that out your bio, but I'm adding it, all right? Now, Nala's mission is to complete her book and share her story with other aspiring business owners in her community. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mrs. Nala Royale Holder. Mrs. I gotta say that, Mrs., because the mister is right there. You know, gotta make sure.
Horace, may I ask your presence again? Of
course. My pleasure.
I gotta tell you, you guys are the best audience ever. I just love you guys. I really do. I'm serious. You're so patient, so kind. I appreciate it because I know we're spending time really making sure that everyone gets their flowers. So thank you for your patience. You got the shot, hubby? You got it? All right.
Clive putting me on the spot. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Can you indulge me for a minute? I want you to repeat what I say, okay? The only thing we love.
The only thing we love
more than good food and drinks.
More than good food and drinks
is you.
Is you.
You the customer. And that really has been our motto for the last almost 20 years. I opened in June 2004, and the premise was: if you're passionate about people and you're passionate about service, then your business will succeed. And that's really been what we've been about. And honestly, without the help of all of my wonderful team, my staff, my mom, who's my inspiration, my husband, who's sitting right here, my friends, none of this would be possible. Clive, you've been a mentor, a friend, a fellow Piscean for all these years, Chris. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you all so much. Congratulations to my fellow honorees. It's just amazing to be recognized for what you do. So thank you.
Thank you so much. Go ahead, Mr. Williams.
I've been her customer for the last almost 20 years. Never left her. Nala, I call her the restaurant genius, because there's nobody that I know, and I've been around restaurants, I've been around the Stone, right? I know stuff. There's nobody who can run a restaurant like this woman. She is a genius. Right, Neil? 100%.
Okay.
So this is why we have to make note and make sure that you're recognized for what you do.
So Nala, Fred, and of course Karen should all be talking, because you're all in the restaurant
Absolutely.
Business. You
Absolutely.
All should be working together.
You all
should be doing stuff together. That's what I'm
Absolutely.
Talking about. All right?
Yeah.
All the restaurateurs here should be working together. That's what I'm talking about.
Yep.
All right? Our next honoree, is Haiti in the building?
Yeah.
Nah, y'all fell asleep.
Yeah.
Is Haiti in the building?
Yeah.
All right, Sakpase. Okay.
All right. Boulay, boy.
I'm telling you. I know the word I was trying to remember. It's Desod. All right. So I've always been called that Desod. Okay. I don't know why.
Was it? Maybe that's not so smart.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I'm a troublemaker. That's what it means. Troublemaker. So anyway, our next honoree is the current president-elect of the Haitian American Lawyers Association of New York. She's also the supervising attorney of the Haitian Response Initiative at Catholic Charities in New York, formed to address the legal and social needs of the rising population of Haitian immigrants in New York. She's also the co-founder and head of content of Tenoir TV. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Ms. Sandra Dudonné. Sandra Dudonné. Dudonné. I just want to say Dudonné. Dudonné. Say it with me. Dudonné. 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 I feel like a chant.
Dudonné.
Dudonné. I feel like it's a chant. Come on. Look at the dress. Look at the dress.
Dudonné.
I'm just saying. She's like, oh my God, I can't believe I know this guy.
Chris, you got to stay on your meds, man.
Listen, I took it tonight. I took my pills at 8:30.
God stay on your meds, man.
You know what it is? I mixed it. I had some alcohol. No, I don't drink. I don't drink, y'all. I don't drink. I am on medication,
Barry,
but not that type of medication.
You want to come on up here, Barry?
It's not that type. I swear it's not.
And present this wonderful lady. This gentleman is an educator in our community and a real fighter for principle. He's presenting the Congressional Award to Ms. Dudonné.
Dudonné. Dudonné.
Dieu.
Dieu. Well, I don't even understand. Like, I spoke French. Come on, son. Son, I know what I'm talking about, son. I've been here too long, folks. I've been here too long. I came here at 14, and now I think I'm American. I don't know what's going on.
Present this certificate of special congressional recognition to Ms. Sandra Dudonné.
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 In recognition of outstanding and invaluable service to the community. Congratulations.
Thank you.
It's pretty heavy. Yes, ma'am.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
My name is actually pronounced Dieu donné, which means God given.
Yeah. So you said I didn't pronounce it right? I thought I said it right.
It was a great effort.
It was a great effort. I'm Jamaican. That's my excuse. I'm Jamaican. I'm sorry.
But I carried that name, Jordanae, with such pride because I feel like God gave me the ability to work and to serve people. My mother and father are not here with me right now. They're back home, but I want to thank them for everything that they've done for me. And I just want to make a plea to everyone with all the Haitian migrants that are coming across the border. I see a majority of them in New York. I work on their asylum cases, their TPS cases, their EAD cards, their SIJ cases, because there are a lot of children that come over without their parents. And we need the community to rally behind them. The Latino community, they have their people behind them. Black immigrants, we are not served. We are not respected, and we need all of us to work together. Prior to working at Catholic Charities, I worked at CUNY. I helped Trinidadians, Jamaicans, Bajans, I helped everyone. And now my work right now is focused solely on the Haitian community, but we need all of us together to stand and speak against the racism that our people are facing. So that's my plea. Again, thank you so much for this honor. And I hope to see you guys at Catholic Charities when we're asking for people to come just to help fill our applications, because we all need the community together.
Yes,
thank you.
We're with you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Barrington.
Our next honoree was born in Kingston, Jamaica, to business-savvy parents who harbored a lifelong thirst for success. Unfortunately, she's unable to be here tonight due to...
Her mother-in-law took ill.
Right.
And she's at the hospital. Situation is kind of tenuous. We don't know what's happening, but Sandra Vassiani is not with us this evening, but Paul, I believe a cousin,
is here.
Paul, are you here?
Paul, where are you? Okay, Paul, please come up so we can accept the award for Miss Sandra Vassiani, who is the owner of Kingston Grill in Elmont, New York.
Right.
Today, it's one of the most successful restaurants in the New York area, and she's been doing remarkable work in the community. So please, Paul, accept the honor for Miss Vassiani. That's it.
Certificate of Special Congressional Recognition presented to Sandra Vassiani in recognition of outstanding and invaluable service to the community.
It is with great honor to accept this on behalf of my cousin Sandy, who would have loved to have been here to do it in person. I just want to say that I do admire her. She is a hard worker, and she's always committed to family and the community. So with great honor, I'll definitely let her know that you guys send her love.
Thank you. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Our next honoree is a businessman, philanthropist, community leader, promoter. These are just a few of the hats that Mr. Saffron Mayor wears. But born Jamaican is the one he wears most proudly. A graduate of CAST UTEC, Saffron worked at the Jamaica Industrial Development Corporation and the National Housing Trust, two agencies devoted to improving Jamaica and Jamaicans. Since migrating and settling in New York in 1982, he furthered his studies at Baruch College with a BA in Business Administration and CPA. He's one of the founders of CAST UTEC Alumni New York Chapter and served as the first president. He also served as a treasurer of the Union of Jamaica Alumni Association. Please put your hands together for Mr. Saffron Mayor.
This gentleman has an academic accounting background, but let me tell you something. He is a marketer. you cannot find a better marketer than Saffron Mayer. Saffron and I worked together on the Jamaica Independence Committee. And let me tell you, we had a couple of weeks to put together a program. And this guy's genius, combined with mine, of course, managed to pull off some stuff that never happened before. But I know Saffron, his heart is for his community, and he puts on events that are just priceless. So make sure that the next time you see anything, what was the name?
Signature
Society. Make sure you look very carefully and attend. Saffron Mayer, ladies and gentlemen, with a congressional award as well. Congratulations. And I've wanted to do this for a long time, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, fellow Piscean, Dr. Clive Williams, Chris, thank you, and the entire where it's at.
He's a Piscean.
Yeah. Chris, you're a Piscean too?
Yeah. And so is my brother over there, Fred Raphael.
Yeah.
So is Nala, all Pisceans.
Yes.
And you too? You too?
We linked together for the Jamaica Independence Gala, and when they told us we were on the promotion marketing committee, we said yeah, and we made it a bash in about 4 or 5 weeks. But I want to speak to you this evening about big. We are being honored tonight for the big things that we do. Signature Society was started several years ago out of a need for big people, adults, to dress up and go out and have fun and not just listen to people talk all night. It was an instant success. We immediately decided that profits from that would go to needy causes. Jerome Hayes, Jerry, you were one of the very first recipients over 10 years ago of the proceeds from Signature Society. Devon Harris was one of our first MCs. Devon? That's true? One of our first MCs. So we go all the way back. So we have sold out all of our events on the New Rochelle, what is it now? The all of the event site over there, the country clubs. 600, 800 people. Last event was sold out 6 weeks before the event day. We have had an event with 3,000 people in the park. But what I want to say tonight is that the thing that I cherish most is not the big things that have me here tonight. It's little things that make big changes. And all of you here are doing that. I want to laud you and ask you to do that and continue to do that. Where most of us here are from the islands or from somewhere else, but even not, you are all part of families that bond. And we know the little things that we do. It's the school fees. It's the funeral expenses. It's the medication. It's the help in the little things. It's the rent. It's all those little things that you will not be awarded for here, but they make big impact in other people's lives. I just want to give you just one relation or one experience that I had just coming back from Jamaica 2 days ago. I'm visiting one of my properties there, and I'm just observing, because it's a lot of rain in Jamaica, I'm observing how lush the grass is. So I'm leaving the property, and I see this lady staring at me, so I stopped to acknowledge her and rolled on my window, and she came up and said, "Mr. Mayor, I've been wanting to talk to you for a long time. I'm just asking for permission for my three little cows to graze the grass." And I'm saying, I live in New York and I have this acres of grass that means nothing to me, but it can change this lady's life. Because I am from a farming community. My uncle was one of the wealthiest persons in Jamaica, and he made it out of farming grass and cows, grass and cows, and they multiply. So I'm saying, this means so much to her, to have her three little cows graze on the grass. That means nothing to me. How many of us here have things that is of no value to you in your closet, in your cupboards, in your pantry, that can make a big impact on other people's lives? Continue to do those little things that you know that when you look in the eyes of someone who you have given something to, the impact it has on them. Continue to do those little things. We know that you are doing them. It's those little things that allow you to get the blessings that you can go on to do big things. Thank you much. God bless you. Get home safe. I love you all.
Trying to get my mic working and fix this mic here. So one of the next honorees, our final honoree for the evening, I want to say, spent her early years in lush St. Catherine and early teens in runaway St. Anne. While her ambition was always in the legal field, she was encouraged to Sam Sharp Teachers College, from which she graduated in 1981. June O'Connor is a parent of one child and a grandparent of a two-year-old grandson. In the process of attempting to place her then three-year-old in a nurturing and culturally affirming environment, June O'Connor's daughter changed her career and life's trajectory. It was the beginning of a daunting yet alluring and encouraging path to a mission in the field of education. June O'Connor is the founder of the Garvey School. Please put your hands together and welcome Miss June O'Connor.
This is very special to me because this lady was at our Mother's Day event. Those of you who, anyone here was at the Mother's Day event that we had last? Okay, a few people are here from that. I introduced the work that this lady is doing in the Bronx, and people were astounded. We managed to raise over $5,000 for her that day, just on the spot. Now, we're not going to do that kind of ask this evening because you have paid quite handsomely to be here this evening. However, I'm going to ask that you place it on your hearts, in your plans, in all your projections that you do to bear the Garvey School in mind. This is not a basic school. This is not a home school. This is a real school. And June will succinctly explain to you what she does and how she does it. But that little daughter that you heard Chris talk about, that June had to find a way to educate her, that daughter is here. Could you stand up, please, ma'am? There she is. Come on over, please. Come stand by your mom. So it was this daughter who is a college graduate, a highly qualified lady, who June made that sacrifice for. She couldn't find a school to suit her needs. So what did she do? She started one. And this is where we are now. The Garvey School is now at a place where we need the community's help. We need all of you to chip in and help because we need to get a new place to house the school. We need a number of things. Just check with me, those of you who have a heart for our children, for our future, check with me and let me know what you can do for the Garvey School, because we're doing everything we can to ensure that that school stays alive. There is no school like that in our community. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Dr. Williams, Clive Williams, Annette, who've just been a net of support for the Garvey School and what it means. And I am so honored to be among all of you who are doing really wonderful things and creating the kind of change in our community that is empowering. and life-changing. And for me, like you, I came here and I wanted to do a certain path, a certain career path. But when my daughter came along, I needed to find a place that was empowering. Having grown up in Jamaica, where most of my teachers looked like me and it was affirming to me, and very early on, I met this enormously influential image on a page, and that was Marcus Messiah Garvey. And I was mesmerized just by the image of this person. Took an interest in who he was, what he represented. Come back to my daughter, it's time for her to be schooled, and I'm living in the Bronx, and I'm unable to find an environment that is affirming, enlightening, culturally affirming, and affordable. Long story short, it wasn't possible, because I then recognized the embedded inequities in the school system, and that if I wanted her to be well-educated comparably to a Hackley or a Rye or any of the very competitive independent schools, she had to be prepared in a certain way. The dilemma for me is that I didn't want her to be the only black child in a sea of white children, because then it would strip her. I'm implicitly teaching her that she's not valued because of her skin color. She needs to be among white students. And so that's when I started to homeschool her. And that grew into others saying, June, what are you doing with your daughter? And I said, it's a long story, but I'm homeschooling her. And so here we are after a while. It couldn't be homeschool anymore. It had to be a school where I had to apply to New York State to satisfy the criteria for a private school. And so I've modeled this school off of just think of any competitive independent school. And that's the content, you know, where the children primarily are culturally affirmed. And I listened to Mr. Graham, and he's so right on spot. It doesn't matter what we offer to our students, if they do not have a sense of self, I don't know how valuable that is, because then they cannot use it to be the person who they can be. If you have no sense of self, you flounder. And so thank you again for affording me the opportunity, for acknowledging the work that we do. And one thing I'd like to leave with all of you, we cannot expect the people who are our oppressors and who created the school system to educate our children. Sure. And if that is to change, we have to have our own schools. And I hope that you believe enough that we can create our own schools, the kind of school that we so desire, that we chase after in all the other communities where they marginalize our scientists, exclude our history, and then teach our children not to believe in who they are. And we are the ones who have to change that. And each time I get a microphone and each time I get an audience, I try to leave this with you, with Marcus Messiah Garvey, something that he has worked very hard to instill in all our minds as people of color. Of you mighty race, and I want you to say it with me, but I want you to listen to it first before you say it. I also want to thank Sadie Campbell, president of the Jamaica Progressive League, who's also been my supporter, and her sister, Dorette, who's also my strong supporter and friend. And of course, my daughter here, who I changed my life for, she's doing really well. Thank you for being here. Up your mighty race, you can accomplish what you will. And I said it very simply and all very lightly. But I'm going to ask you to say it with meaning, with passion, with belief, and with a reaffirming belief in the idea that we own the responsibility to educate our children well. And when we send our children to those schools where they learn a lot of content, but not our own content, right? That's sanitized and prepared for that school community. I want us, just for this moment, if it is, even for this moment, to believe that we are the mighty race that Marcus Messiah Garvey talked about. He said, up you mighty race, you can accomplish what you will. I am going to say two more times, and then you will say loudly and believing in what you say. And if you believe it, I'm going to hear it. And you are going to feel it. So up, you mighty race. you can accomplish what you will. I'll say it again. Up, you mighty race, you can accomplish what you will. With me now. Up, you mighty race, you can accomplish what you will. One more time, and I want you to tear the roof off, and I want you to feel it in your heart, and I want you to leave here believing that we are the mighty race. Up, you mighty race, you can accomplish what you will. Thank you all.
Tell you, it doesn't end there. Tomorrow evening, after today, tomorrow evening, June and I will have a Zoom meeting with the lawyers, not going to be on, right? But some other folks who have a vested interest in making sure that the Garvey School continues to live. You understand, we can't afford to lose this. Your pockets are deep. Compared, do you realize the people in this room, how fortunate you are, the fact that you can come out this evening like this? You represent about maybe 2-3% of the world's population. Believe that. Believe that. And if you represent that small percentage of people who can afford to drive a car to find entertainment, enjoy yourself without worrying about it, then spread that good fortune with others. I'm asking you to make sure that the Garvey School stays alive. Call me, and if you call me, I will know that your heart is in the right place.
Thank you very much, Mr. Williams. I appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together once again for our honorees. These are our 2023 Big Award honorees. I would like to ask all of the honorees to join the photographers in the room, the reception hall where we were earlier, so we can get some more pictures with you and your wonderful awards, your prizes, your trophies. Hold them gently. Please take them, follow the photographers back there. So all the honorees, carry the awards with you, your citations with you. If you have a loved one with you that can help you carry it, please do that. And you got to turn it on. Yes.
Yeah, he turned off my mic.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, I want you to stand. Just stand, please. Get to your feet. You've been sitting too long. Please stand.
You want to do some
folks,
jumping jacks?
Please stand.
We're doing jumping jacks?
No, not yet. Okay. We're not at jumping jacks yet. But please stand. Please stand. Thank you so very much. In honor, put your hands together in honor of these incredible people. Thank you so much. Now we get a chance to dance.
Yes, now you get a chance to dance. So DJ Candy is going to give you some great music. I want to make sure that we thank the staff of Garden City Casino, who has been doing a great job making sure you get your food and beverages. Thanks to Jackie, Katie Ann. Big thanks to my mom, Annette, Stone, Jonathan, everyone who's been helping to make things happen. Mr. DJ Candy, please, sir, do your thing while the honorees go get their pictures.
Thank you. burden. You're still so high, and it's blowing my mind. I know I should pack and walk away, leave you nothing to remind. When you're wrapped up in my arms, dancing to a reggae.